Prevention of Domestic Violence Act entered the law books in 2005. And when it became a law, I happened to be working in Parliament, and it was presented by a male justice minister, and it was supported also by male parliamentarians. I was deeply perturbed to see a woman parliamentarian saying that this is inappropriate for Sri Lanka because women, slaves and drums are meant to be beaten up. Then I realized that for centuries we have accepted violence against women when it happens within the four walls of one's house, saying that it is a normal thing and that we shouldn't cry out for help even if it causes terrible emotional strain and psychological violence. But as time went on, the Prevention of Domestic Violence Act was used as a teaching tool, and in police trainings, in trainings of rural women, women's societies, we told them it was okay to ask for help when you find it impossible. It's not that we advocate separation between couples, but when it becomes impossible, then a woman has to seek help. Otherwise, we know that in Sri Lanka, the suicide rate is very high. And till it comes to that extreme situation, one should not go on but ask for help. I realized that we have to look at this problem holistically. It's not just going to court and getting a protection order so that the perpetrator cannot come anywhere near the woman. Because where do you send the man out? You're sending the man out of the house and saying, this place is out of bounds for you. That's what the court does. But where does he go? Does he go to his parents' house and start abusing them? Use physical violence or emotional abuse on them? The urgent need was to give the woman, or if she's coming with her children, a space, a very relaxing environment where she could come and spend a few hours or maybe a few days, and for her to decide what she's going to do with her life. Is she going back to her parents? Is she going back to the husband? Does she want income generation training to stand on her own feet and be economically empowered and start a new life with her children in a new home? So that kind of space was not available in Sri Lanka. They just passed this act in Parliament, but this supporting mechanism was not available. So I decided to have my own shelters, one in Hikkadu and one in Colombo. Colombo shelter is still functioning, and it's registered with the Department of Probation, and the women development officers, the police, the Women's Bureau of the Sri Lanka Police and the Probation Department keeps on sending victims. And for each of these victims, we go to court, we prepare their documents, we prepare a care plan. First we ask them what they want to do, give them options on what they can do with their lives, and give them a new beginning where they close the chapter and we help them to move on. There's a famous book written by Amina Hussein based on research saying sometimes there is no blood. So the Prevention of Domestic Violence Act was the first act that recognized emotional abuse as a form of violence. So name calling, putting one down, depriving of funds, sufficient funds for the woman, not allowing her to do an occupation of her choice, all this amounts to emotional abuse. So all this has a tremendous impact on the woman leading a normal life. And you cannot see it from outside, like physical violence, you cannot see the emotional impact, the mental agony that the woman goes through. My main problem is that we don't have sufficient counselors who are willing to work pro bono to talk to these women, to do kind of art therapy with these women, dance therapy. There's so much that is done in other countries. This kind of therapy is not freely available. The poor people, the rural people, the needy, the poor women and children who live below the poverty line don't have access to free counseling, and that is a huge problem, because we cannot only do the legal
part and ignore the counseling part of it. It has to go parallelly. Either the government should provide that service, or there should be volunteerism. Women might come forward and ask for help if they are comfortable with the service we offer. So I believe in going to the women, to the victims, and this can be done by creating awareness of the women development officers, the child protection officers who are there in every divisional secretariat and in every district secretariat. They should network with organizations such as us, and they should display notices and posters in the midwife's office, in the local doctor's office, in local hospitals, saying that do not suffer in silence. If you're suffering domestic violence, refer them to us, and we will do what we can to help them to come out of this horrible situation and to face life with confidence and be happy once more.